Amendment to the amendment in the nature of a substitute to H.R. 2480 offered by Mrs. McBath.
Gentlelady from Georgia.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Children are truly the future of our country, and our next teachers, they're our next doctors, they're our next police officers, and they're our next members of Congress. And it's our responsibility to do everything that we can to protect them and make sure that our children are able to live, learn, and grow up in safe environments. That's why I'm happy that we are coming to a bipartisan consensus on this legislation, H.R. 2480, the Stronger Child Abuse Prevention and Treatment Act. I'm especially pleased to be introducing this amendment with my colleagues across the aisle. Congresswoman Elise Stefanik, our amendment would establish a national children's abuse hotline to provide a necessary resource for victims of child abuse. And my home state of Georgia ranked 5th in the nation for the highest number of child abuse-related deaths in 2017, and 3rd for calls to hotlines to report abuse. Parents, youth, mandated reporters, and any other concerned community member can call the National Child Abuse Hotline when looking for immediate help and support during moments of crisis and doubt. And establishing this National Child Abuse Hotline, we will be one step closer to saving our children's lives. And this amendment is important not only for Georgia, but for the nation. So I do encourage my colleagues to vote yes on this amendment. And thank you, and I yield back the balance of my time.
Does someone else wish to speak? The co-sponsor of the amendment, Ms. Stefanik.
Thank you, Chairman. I'm proud to have co-led this amendment with my colleague across the aisle, Ms. McBath. This improves the bill. I'm proud to be an original co-sponsor of the underlying bill, a stronger CAPTA, because not only does it improve support for the state systems, but it focuses on prevention with the goal of stopping child abuse and neglect before it ever happens. And part of preventing child abuse and neglect is providing that information and assistance to youth seeking help. So as Ms. McBath pointed out, in many cases, children want information, yet they don't feel comfortable going to an adult they know. Sometimes they want to talk to someone to better understand if what they are seeing or experiencing is abuse or neglect. In some cases, adults want to understand specifically how they can report or what they can do to stop child abuse and neglect. So a hotline, whether that is a telephone line or a text or chat system, this is a critical aspect of providing that information in a non-threatening way. So I am proud to support this amendment, which adds a demonstration project to provide funding for this national hotline to prevent child abuse. I appreciate the work across the aisle. This strengthens the bill. I urge my colleagues to support it, and I yield back.
Thank you. Is there further debate on the amendment? If not, the question is on the amendment offered by the gentlelady from Georgia. All in favor will say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Opinion of the chair, the ayes have it. The ayes have it, and the amendment is agreed to. Next order of business is an amendment